रूट ऑफ एल टू बाई एल वन, एन वन अपॉन एन टू इज 4/1 इन रूट, एन वन अपॉन एन टू इज 2/1, एन वन इज 2 times n2. Whenever you see product is constant, something n2, something n1. So find LCM. LCM of 1 comma 2 equals to 2. So my left hand side should be 2, right hand side should be 2. So n1 should be 2 and n2 should be 1, then only 2 equal to 2 it will be. So when Shorter has completed 2 oscillation, then again they will be in phase with each other. Shorter has completed 2 oscillation is given in option A. First, you followed the logic, what we did?
Yes, sir. So, can you explain the LCM part again?
See, whenever you see like this, something like this, x1, y1 equal to x2, y2. That means product is constant?
Yes, sir.
Then always take LCM of the other, whichever is known. So, I took 1 and 2 ka LCM. Because here, then this should become 2 and this also should become that concept. Even in light chapter, it will come.
Answer.
57. Length of second spindulum. Formula is G upon pi square. G upon pi square means C option. Next. A pendulum clock has period T on earth. When this clock is placed on moon, what will happen? Pendulum clock. Time period of pendulum is 2 pi root L by G. At moon, G will decrease. So T will increase. That means watch will run slow because it is taking more time to complete one oscillation. It will run slow. Time increases, that means not faster, it is slow. 59. Pendulum of length L1 has time period 4 seconds, length L2 3 seconds. Then what will be time period when length is L1 minus L2? So, 2 time given, use that ratio. You will get relation between L1 and L2. So, 4/3 is L1 upon L2. 16 upon 9 is L1 upon L2. Therefore, L2 is 9/16 L1. Then T1 upon T3 will become L1 upon L1 minus L2 in root. T1 4, T3 we want. L1 I don't know. L2 is 9/16 times L1. So 4/T3 is L1 upon 16 minus 9. 7 L1 upon 16 in root. L1 and 1 cancel. 4/T3 is 16 upon 7 in root. So 4/T3 equals to 4/√7. Therefore, T3 equals to root 7. 59 answer, root 7. कंप्लीटेड.
1 minute. Done, sir.
Sum number 60. A simple pendulum has a time period T. The support and pendulum falls freely, then the time period will be. If it is falling freely, that means G is zero. If G is zero, then time period will be infinity. Answer right? Infinity. Next. A simple pendulum with a bob of iron is oscillating over horizontal plane pole of electromagnet. If strength of current of the electromagnet is increased, then the frequency of oscillation will. When a pendulum with bob made up of iron is moving between magnet, that means it is getting attracted by magnet. Always iron is attracted. So if attracted means we say restoring force is increasing. If restoring force increasing, that means velocity is increasing. If velocity increasing, that means it will move fast. So time period will decrease and frequency will increase. Clear? Reason right properly. Restoring force will increase. Restoring force increases. Therefore, velocity increases. Time period decreases. Time period decreases. Therefore, the frequency will increase.
Answer.
Okay. Next one is next homework. You all try. Actually, by mistake, it is 61 to 72. It is 62 only. So please try. Whichever you don't get, I will explain in the class.
I did like the homework part. I have doubts.
Which sum?
I did like all the homework, so I have.
No. So which doubt? I don't know.
73.
The phase angle between two projection of uniform circular motion on any two mutually perpendicular diameter. That one?
Yes, sir.
First of all, we should understand what is meaning of projection. If this is one line, this is x-axis, projecting means dropping perpendicular. It's called projection. So if AB is line, then its projection is PQ on x-axis. If I draw perpendicular on y-axis, then this will be called as projection on y-axis. So here they are saying if body is performing the phase angle between two projection of UCM on mutually perpendicular diameter. This is circular motion. So its projection on x-axis will be this point and y-axis will be this point. What is angle between them? One is here, other is here. So 90 degree, no?
Yes, sir.
Answer 90 degree. After this, which one?
77.
A particle is performing SHM along x-axis with amplitude 4 and time period 1.2 second. Amplitude 4 and time period 12 second. Amplitude is 4, time period 12. Shortest minimum time it will take to move from 2 centimeter and 4 centimeter and back. So from 2 centimeter to 4 centimeter minimum time taken and back. This is the question. Now, if I take, whenever in between given, you always think from start. So start to this 2 is suppose time t1. And start to extreme is time t2, then this interval will be t2 minus t1. Okay? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Now, a by 2 is center, na 4 ka amplitude 4 hai. So, ek mein bhi derivation karta ho, bahad karke rakhna hai thoda. From mean to extreme time t equals to 1/4 of time period. This I should remember. Then from mean to midway, x is a sine omega t, midway means a by 2, this is 2 pi by time period into t, sine of which angle is half? 30 degree. 30 means pi by 6. So that is 2 pi by t into t. Therefore, time is t by 12. So always remember, from mean to extreme t by 4. From mean to midway t by 12. If I remember this, then I will not do this method.
Yes, sir.
So I will assume that I have remembered t by 4 and t by 2. So time between midway to extreme will be t by 4 minus t by 12?
From 2 centimeter to 4 centimeter, no? Huh. Got it.
So LCM is 12. This is 3t minus 1t. So this will become 2t upon 12. T by 6. So this also we can remember. Three things you have to remember now. Mean to extreme T by 4. Mean to midway T by 12. And midway to extreme T by 6. So that means it is 1.2 upon 6. 0.2 second. So total time to go and come back will be 0.4 second. The lengthy sum, if I don't know this, huh? Because then I have to find x equal to a sine omega t t1 say t1, then a sine omega t2 t say t2, subtract double. If I know directly, I will say t by 6 cut double. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Just write somewhere this all things and practice 2-3 times. Afterwards, mean to extreme t by 4, mean to midway t by 6, or t by 12, midway to extreme t by 6. Write everything properly.
Done, sir.
Next sum?
Next
78. A body is oscillating vertically. That one?
Yes, sir.
A body is oscillating vertically about its mean position with period root 3 seconds. If its maximum and minimum height from the surface of ground are 2 meters and 1.5. Are 1.5 meter and 2 meter from the ground. Then the speed midway between mean and extreme. So this is nothing but path length, na? Total. Path length is this distance 1.5 and 2 ka difference. So path length is 2 meter minus 1.5 meter, that is 0.5 meter. This part first call it path length.
Yes, sir.
Now, once I know path length means I know twice the amplitude is 0.5, so A equals to 0.25 meter. They want velocity between mean and extreme. So, velocity between mean and extreme means any point omega root of A square minus X square. So this is 2 pi by time period root of A square minus midway is A square by 4. I directly wrote in square form. So 2 pi by T, 4 A square minus A square is 3 square by 4. So this is 2 pi upon T is root 3. Root 3 A upon 2. So root 3 cancel. 2 cancel, pi into 0.25. Pi answer pi mein hai. Haan hai. Pi by 4. Pi by 4 meter per second.
Answer.
Then some number 81. The displacement of a particle performing SHM is given by y equals to 4 cos square half t sine of 1000. Y is 4 cos square half t sine of 1000 t. Okay, aage question aisa hona chahiye. This is combination of how many SHM? This is made up of how many SHM? This is the question. So, one SHM means one trigonometric function, sine or cos. Like suppose I have got like this, A sine omega t, one SHM. Plus A2 sine omega t, two SHM. So if I can adjust this in the form of terms containing single sign, single cos, that many term is our composition of SHM. Mm. So 4 sine 1000 t cos square theta can be written as 1 plus cos 2 theta upon 2 wala formula. Cos square theta is 1 plus cos 2 theta. Cos 2 theta is cos square minus sine square. This is the formula. So cos 2 theta is cos square theta minus 1 minus cos square theta. That will become 2 cos square theta minus 1. So for trigonometric function, first of all, for SHM, power of sin cos should be 1. So isko 1 ka power mein convert kiya. That means I thought cos square theta. Cos square theta is 1 plus cos 2 theta upon 2. So this is 4 sine 1000 t 1 plus cos our theta is half t upon 2. That means cos t upon 2. So this is y equals to 2 sine 1000 t plus 2 sine 1000 t into cos of t. Till this, any doubt? Hello? So this is one SHM, and this means it is combo of two, because product can be converted into sum. You know,
yes,
this?
Sir. Yes, sir.
So total how many SHM? Very important one. Okay, done. After this,
84.
The ratio of instantaneous speed at the center to average speed of particle. Speed at center to average speed of particle. What is speed at center? In SHM, speed at center is how much?
Maximum.
That is A omega. Now average speed equals to total displacement upon total time. This is average speed. Now total time, if I take time period, then total distance is 4a. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Now this A is 2 pi by omega. So this will become 2A omega upon pi. Now A omega is V maximum upon pi. They want ratio. Ho gaya na fir? Ratio of speed at center, matlab V maximum upon average speed. So V maximum upon average is 2 upon pi V maximum. V maximum cancel, pi by 2. Pi by 2, C is the option. Then after this,
1 minute.
Which one?
1 minute, I'm writing. So then 94 and 95.
Two particles P and Q perform acceleration of same amplitude and frequency along same straight line. Resultant acceleration has amplitude root 2 times amplitude. Then phase difference between them is on. Simple, no? It is like two vectors are of same amplitude. Result is root 2a. What is phase difference? What is our resultant amplitude formula? A square plus a square plus 2aa cos of phase difference. Cos of phase difference. Now, if you have understood vector and remembering, then angle should be 90 degree for root 2.
Yes, sir.
Chalega directly likh do. Phase difference 90 degree or 5. 95th is good sign. If a particle performs acceleration from mean position of amplitude at period T, then the lapse of fraction of period in 7th, 8th oscillation will be how much? 7th, 8th oscillation mein, what will be the time period gone? At midway, what is time?
T by 2. Achha, there's T by 12.
T by 12. At extreme?
T by 4.
T by 4. They want not in time but in oscillation. How many oscillation? After 7th, 8th oscillation, what is time? Correct?
Yes, sir.
7 by 8th oscillation, what is time? This is half oscillation. Hello?
Yes, sir.
And this is one oscillation. 1/4 oscillation.
That will be 1/8.
What will be that?
No, the middle one has a half. That's not the main position.
That's a lot of disturbance is there. Once again, say.
No, I'm not understanding what you're saying.
No, what you understood that you revealed first.
The first point is the main position, correct?
You forget about these lines. So this diagram is in our hand, na? Wherever you want to show, you can show me.
Hmm.
What you have?
So mean to extreme is T by 4, and midway is T
time.
By 12.
This is time.
Hmm.
Time. We are interested in terms of oscillation. So after 7 by how much that is? 7 by
8. 7 by 8.
After 7 by 8 oscillation, what is the time period passed? Fraction means part of time period. Whether it is half time period to 1/4, 1/5. So I should know what is meaning of oscillation. From here to here, how many oscillation?
Half.
Half. 1/4 it is, not half. 1/4, no?
Yeah, because like other side also half.
From mean to extreme, and this is half, this is now 3/4, this is 1. So till this, how many oscillation? 1/4. If they ask only for one oscillation, I will say time is T by 4. Correct? Not followed.
Followed, sir.
Now 1 by 4. And here it will come, it will become half, na? But I am taking like this. 1/8, 2/8, 3/8, 4/8, 5/8, 6/8. So easy. So in terms of 8, this is nothing but 2 by 8. Na?
2 by 8, yeah.
This is 2 by 8. When you come here, this will become what? 4 by 8.
4 by 8.
2 by 8, again 2 by 8, 4 by 8.
4 by 8, yes.
And here?
6 by 8.
6 by 8. Now only one more we want. Na? So if it comes here, it will become 8 by 8.
Yes, sir.
So here it will be what? 7 by 8?
7 by 8.
So this is center or midway between mean and extreme, but on left side. How much is time from here to here? 3 by 12. So khatam ho gaya na, total t minus t by 12 na. Because idhar se aaya gaya, ek oscillation khatam ho gaya tha na idhar tak. So it will be 12 t minus this. This is not the difficult one, but once again. Some number 97,
na? 95.
We want time after 7 by 8 oscillation. So I'm assuming everything in 1/8. This is actually 1/4 oscillation, but we can write this is 2/8 oscillation, meaning it's same. So 2 by 8, 2 by 8, 4 by 8, 6 by 8, and at center it will become 7 by 8. If it could have reached here, then it is one oscillation. So now time is time for one oscillation minus time for this one. Na?
Yes, sir.
So that, so we proved that it is T by 12.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Difficult some concept, some jato easy. 11 T by 12. Then after this,
sir, 99th question answer will be 20 joule only, no?
No, average they want. If the potential energy of particle is midway between mean and extreme is 5, then average total energy will be how much? Total energy is always constant. Yes, it should be 20 joule. Maybe kinetic energy vagara kuch hoga.
Then 101.
Displacement of particle performed position is given by 101. The displacement of particle performing a section is P sin T14 plus O cos T14. Initial case. By comparing, what is A13?
Yes, sir.
Delta 1 is 0, A2 is 4, and delta 2 is 90. This part here? This much?
Yes, sir.
Because to compare, it should be in sine. So this is like sine of 90 plus theta. So tan delta formula is A1 sine delta 1 plus A2 sine delta 2 upon A1 cos delta 1 plus A2 cos delta.
Now I understood. I was just not getting that delta 1 and delta 2.
Okay. So 3 sin 0 plus 4 cos 0 upon 3 cos 0 plus 4 cos 3 cos delta 2 is 9. Now I think you got 4 by 3 is the answer.
Yes, sir.
Then which one?
Then 103 and 104.
103, 104. If simple pendulum with bob of mass m, this is the diagram. A simple pendulum of mass of m oscillates from A to C and back to A such that T to the height is h, then velocity as it passes from B will be how much? What is velocity here, can you tell? In SHM at extreme position, what is velocity?
Zero.
So at extreme, B is zero. Mm. So total energy is only potential energy. When it falls here, total energy will be only kinetic energy.
Mm-hmm.
So by law of conservation of energy, I can say loss in potential will be gain in kinetic energy. Loss in potential means mgh, gain in kinetic half mv square. So v square equals to 2gh, v is the root of it. Okay.
Answer.
104. Can you read that, sir? 104. Just read 104.
The length of seconds pendulum is increased by 2%. How many seconds will it lose per day?
In one day, how much clock will lose if length is increased by 2%? So one shortcut method I think. See, suppose original time, first understand, right? Original time is t1, there is no loss, perfect vessel. So if time t2 aya, different than this, so ghadi slow nahi to fast ho sakta hai na? If t2 comes greater, that means our watch will run slow, there will be loss, because it is taking more time to complete one oscillation. So imagine if T2 is greater, then loss in T2 is T2 minus T1. Mm. So in one day, that means 24 into 3600 second, loss will be T2 minus T1 into 24 into 36 into 100 upon that T2. So this is like T2 minus T1 upon T2 into 100 into 864. This is called percentage loss or percentage gain. Agar bada rahega to loss, chota rahega to gain. So I have created one formula. Percentage loss or gain in pendulum clock equals to percentage change in t into 864. This please memorize. then in just 30 seconds I will be able to get my answer. So percentage loss or gain in pendulum is how much? Percentage change in T into 864. This much clear or any difficulties there?
So no, I got it.
Now see how to start. Now it is only one more line. We know T is proportional to root L. That means L raised to half. So percentage change T is half of L, which is half of 2, which is equals to 1%. So loss equals to percentage. Khali loss or gain equals to percentage of T into 864. Answer 864. Hai option? This option is 64. So now, as per this sheet, you are clear with everything, correct?
Yes, sir.
Now, so your target is? Keep on practicing from universal, full circular motion and full oscillation. Again, I forget today, without fail, I will send you the paper of circular motion and Sunday oscillation. So by this Sunday, your this two chapter should be perfect.
Yes, sir.
Now we will start with gravitation. See, I have completed Ashlesha for you chapter measurement, scalars vector, kinematics. Kinematics ke baad kya kiya? Theek hai, oscillation, circular motion. Itne kiya kya aur kiya hai kuch chapter?
Yeah, this much only.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we are doing 6 chapters, that is gravitation. This is actually 2 chapters now. The motion.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So after gravitation, I have told what I will start.
Newton's law of motion.
Newton's law of motion. Yes. After this, I will start with Newton's law of motion. Work for energy. Somebody wanted. Whenever you say gravity, that means it is related to pull by Earth, no? Any planet. So Newton suggested that every particle of matter is attracted by every particle of another matter by force. So if you take any point masses, m1, m2, there will be always attraction. In case of charges, there can be attraction, there can be repulsion. But force of attraction between two point mass is given by G into M1, M2 upon R square. G is universal gravitational constant. Its value is 6.67 into 10 raised to minus 11. Newton meter square or kg square. Dimension of G is m minus 1 L3 T minus 2. You can get from here. Newton is m1, L1 T minus 2, meter is L2. Mass is M2. So from this I got M minus 1 L3 T minus 2. 4. When mass capital M is split into two masses, then for maximum force, M1 should be, M2 should be M upon 2. Now, roughly, I am explaining why it is like that. We know force is G, M1, M2 upon R square. So, if M1 is suppose small m, M2 is total M minus M upon R square. So, this will be G, M into capital M minus M square upon R square. For maximum or minimum, derivative must be zero. So, derivative of force with respect to mass, G upon R square constant. What is derivative of 4x?
4.
4x, 4, 5x, 5, 3x, 3 and so on. So, this m is constant, small m is variable. So, this will become only constant m. Minus 2 times m. But for maxima or minima, this should be 0. So m minus 2m should be 0. Therefore, m should be 2m. That means small m is capital M upon 2. So that's why first mass or second mass, it must be m by 2. Very important. Is much clear?
Yes, sir.
So sometimes they can say masses are split into two parts for maximum force. What is ratio of that mass? So capital M is always twice of small m, or small m is always half. Just copy this one.
Done, sir.
No, full till this. All the 4 points? First, yes, second, third. If three equal masses are at vertices of triangle, what is net force at centroid? Net force at centroid. See, if I take this as center O, centroid always divides the median in 2:1 or angle bisector. So distances are same, na? From A to O, B to O, C to O. Are they same?
Yes, sir.
If distance is same and mass is same, that means forces are same. So one attractive force will act here, other attractive force will be here, and third attractive force will be this one. Okay. Now two forces are equal. What is this angle? This much? 30. 30, na? 30. This is 30. So what about this angle? 120?
Yes, sir.
So, 2 force equal angle is 120. Result is how much? Same as given vector?
Yes, sir.
So, what will be net then? Zero.
Zero.
So this is one of the important questions.
Okay.
Right. Ashlecha, you are using laptop?
Yes, sir.
Bahut awaaz aa raha hai. Pad nahi hai, iPad nahi hai, no?
नो सर लैपटॉप.
हाँ लैपटॉप तो ठीक है, पैड्स में बहुत आवाज आती है. अब ये डिस्टर्बेंस क्यों आ रहा है पता नहीं, बट यू आर एडजस्टिंग प्रॉपरली. व्हेन एवर यू वांट टू स्पीक यू कीप. सो एट सेंट्रोइड नेट फोर्स इज जीरो. सेम थिंग कैन बी इवन इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स. So if I am doing this first now, so many concept of electrostatic and magnetism will be involved in this, or the same concept we can use there.
Done, sir.
So today we stop here. Tomorrow, as usual, I will continue now gravitation. Saturday, it will be possible for you all, or you want Ganesh Chaturthi holiday?
I have 5 days Ganpati at home.
Okay. So tomorrow we'll have lecture. Friday, Saturday we will not have. Sunday we will not have.
Okay.
Monday it's okay if I keep?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. No problem.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So tomorrow, same time, gravitation. Okay. And Ananya, you don't have exam this Sunday, na, physics ka?
No, sir.
And next Sunday, gravitation wala part hai?
That is not, they haven't told us the portion for next Sundays yet.
But usually they give on the last test only, na?
Yeah, but then this Sunday there's no test, so they'll give it on Sunday, no? The physics is not there, so they give it on... So every Sunday after the test is over, they give the portion.
Of next week?
So, yeah, so like on this Sunday, they gave us bio and chem ka portion. So that now...